You know, if somebody dies, or if somebody's wife dies, or if somebody's in the hospital, a workplace will get together and pitch in and go visit and send flowers. They do that as to show their love. Listen, if the workplace does that, how are we lacking? And we say we love.
Come on.
I want us to be able to cultivate some compassion within this building right here. Mm-hmm. That we would begin to love one another like the Lord teaches us to love.
Right.
And you know what? That's a giving away of yourself and the way that you think it should be. And then you say, well, Brother Scott, then somebody else will get their way. That's really what you said.
That's right.
You might not say it out loud.
Come on.
The Bible says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. I want to change your way of thinking.
Come on.
I want you to reach out and grab hold of the compassion that Jesus has loved us with. And then I want you to turn and share that compassion with people who are just as undeserving as you were.
Sorry.
Because I know that there are people out there that, to my carnal eye, are undeserving.
That's right.
But yet, while we were yet sinners,
that's
Christ
right.
died for us. Now listen, if the answer of my mouth can bring me joy, then I want the right answer.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And it's more than $1 million at stake.
That's right. That's right.
It's eternity.
Mm-hmm.
Joy is the kingdom position. Are you advancing the kingdom of God? You see, what I want to happen is I want to one of us face a wall that seems insurmountable. You say, well, Brother Scott, why would you want that? Because I want to show you what God can do.
All right. That's right.
I want to show you what my God can do.
Come on.
Because my God is amazing.
Yeah.
Amen. He's amazing. And
right.
So you see, when you get up against a defense position, I don't want us to be in a foxhole entrenched in one position. I want us to be on the move.
Yes. Come on.
Taking ground from God. And when one of us gets a letter from the front to say, hey, listen, I got a big deal over here. There's a lot of stuff going on. And I want you all to come over and help me. I want the platoon leader to shout back and say, bring up the joy!
Come on.
Come on, bring up the joy! Bring up the joy! The Bible says like a well that you can draw from the joy of your salvation, and you can realize that as much as God loves you, He loves them.
Right.
That much.
That's right.
With joy. You know, I think of the carnal weaponry that we know of warfare. And when we fought with muskets, the cannon was a big deal. Amen?
Right.
And so when the side that had the cannon brought the cannons forward, the other side wasn't so happy about that. Amen? You see, I want us to be like that and draw the joy up to the front line and say that wall just don't matter.
That's right.
Because the joy of the Lord is our strength. You look at Joshua going around the city of Jericho. Joshua went around the city of Jericho, and the instructions that he received were
different.
Yeah, to say the least, they were different. So I want you to go and march your army around the city. Well, should we take our spears? Should we take our bows and arrows? No, just go and march around the city. And don't make noise. March in obedience. And they did that. They did that, 6 days? And on the seventh day, they said, okay, I want you to do the same thing today, but this time I want you to blow the trumpet and shout. Shout for the victory. Shout because you've been set free. Yes.
Amen.
Shout.
Amen. Amen.
I want you to be able to shout. Okay, so on the seventh day, the most defended city. Walls so thick, they say, that four chariots could race around the top of them. When the people of God were in obedience and began to shout, those walls, they came down. Now let me take you into the day. You don't face a problem that's bigger than Jericho. You don't face a problem that's bigger than Goliath. You don't face a problem that's bigger than a lion's den or a fiery furnace. It doesn't matter what the world looks like. Our God is an awesome God.
Sure is.
He can bring the victory to you just like He's brought it to me and to the patriarchs of the Bible, the Old Testament characters and the New Testament saints. God brings the victory. We can advance joy across the field. Amen. And you know what? That might take a change in the way that you look at things.
That's right.
And what you let come out of your mouth. A man hath joy by the answer of his mouth. I want that wisdom to trickle down to the depths of your soul. And I want you to ask yourself, how do I answer? Say, Brother Scott, how do I answer what? How do you answer, period? You know, some folks don't talk to you because of the way that you answer.
Right.
Come on now.
Mm-hmm.
Ring, ring. What? Now, listen, now we got caller ID, right? Did you know you're answering then, too? Right. Oh, I don't want to talk to him. He'll go on and on and on. I don't have time for that right now. So we just text.
What if you hear the voice like that in the text?
Hush. A man hath joy by the answer of his mouth. You see, you know, I've been... There's been some people that say things about me that aren't necessarily true, but I'm happy with who God has made me to be, and I want to be more like Him tomorrow than I am today.
Amen.
And I believe the way that I can answer people, and I want to tell you, you want some ammunition, stock up, because there's going to be an inventory. Take it.
Come on.
It's going to be, and it's more than just a letter that you're going to have to write. There's going to be an inventory taken. And you know what? I want you to be able to have the answer that brings that joy. Would you stand with me this morning? I'm going to ask Brother Johnny, if he would, to come to...